Hi guys and welcome to Starcity Tutorials. My name is Jay Picasso and today I'll be going through how to bus reverb and potentially why we bus reverb as well. So we're going to get straight into it. I'm just going to play you guys what I have in front of me. Okay, so it's a little house beat I was working on earlier. For those of you that saw the sidechain compression, you'll recognize the pattern in front of me. But we are looking at a slightly different aspect of this music production today. So we're going to get straight into it by adding our reverb. Now, normally what you would do, for example, if I solo my kick drum, what normally you would do is, I'm assuming that most of you would go and add a reverb unit here, which is in our audio effects, and you're not wrong to do so. Okay, but if we want to sort of maximize the use of our CPU, for those of you using laptops, and you often get that message that comes up saying that you've overloaded something, this is a way to reduce that from happening. And also this is a way for us to get all of our drums sounding very, very much the same. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna go down here on the left, and underneath the audio effects, we're gonna click on this option which says send. On send, you're going to go down to bus and you're going to select the next available bus. Now, I set these up earlier, but for the sake of showing you guys how I did this, we're going to go to the next available one. For those of you that are using Logic 9 or 10, you will find that sometimes with your sessions, they've set these up automatically, even if you haven't. So as I said, just go to the next available one, and it's usually one with nothing else on it. So in my instance, it's going to be bus 3. So I'm going to select bus 3. And now to bus 3, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add my reverb here. So I'm going to add some space designer, pretty standard. Just going to turn up the reverb a little bit so we can be sure to hear its effect. And I'm going to close that. Now, before I go ahead with this, I am going to just answer another question that came in very, very briefly. And that was about mud in reverb, which is a common occurrence when using reverb on songs. It can be quite a detrimental thing to your music if not used appropriately. So now, how to get rid of some of the mud that comes through to reverb is very, very simple. We're going to stack an EQ underneath our reverb here, and all we're going to do is we're going to take away 80 hertz or more, depending on your mix, of course. But we're essentially going to get rid of the bottom end where the mud lies. So everything in the reverb unit now will only be affecting this region here. So if I now add my reverb to here, we're given the option to increase its volume. So what we don't have to deal with, like before when we had it on here, is we don't have to deal with oversaturation. Now we can choose how much of that reverb unit we want to add to our instrument as we go. So I'm just going to add it here as I play it back. Okay, and it's really that simple. Now, the reason why we have done it like this is because we want to keep our drums in the same room. So what I'm actually going to do, and be sure to do this every time, is I'm going to label this reverb room. Now, it's not actually a room. I've called it that for a specific reason. The reason being is because when we add, for example, if we added this same reverb unit to every single one of our drum channels individually and put it on the audio effects here, yes, we are using the same reverb, but essentially we're putting rooms on all of our instruments rather than putting our instruments through the same room. So this concept allows us to kind of better get a grip of how our drums sit in a mix if we put them through the same reverb room. It can be a delay room, it can be anything. So I'm just going to add the reverb to the rest of the instruments as well. And of course, you can add as much or as little as you want. So I'm going to leave that there for now. Now, what you would normally consider is that I wouldn't put reverb necessarily on my kick drums. There are exceptions to every rule. However, with a kick drum, it generally is very, very punchy and will generate a lot more mud that you just don't need. So be very considerate, and I would always suggest applying light reverb. Now, as I said, there are exceptions to every rule. If you're creating a very new style of music or something like that, where it's, you know, a very reverby kick, then by all means, go ahead and have your day. But just consider that, you know, certainly in pop music and other genres like that, we will be very, very sparing on our use of reverb over our kick drum. So just to see how this now corresponds to other things that we can add, I'm going to add a delay unit as well in the same way. So I'm going to go down here and I'm going to go to my next available bus, which in this case is bus 4, and I'm going to label that in advance as well, just so I know what I'm talking about. Okay, call that delay. Audio effects, go to my delay unit, go to tape delay. Just change that option there and close that. Now I'm going to add that to my clap and see what its effect is. So just so we can hear the clap. So we can see that as I bring it in, we can hear the echoes, or rather the delays happening on the clap there. Now, for example, if I also wanted to add that same delay to my hi-hats, I'd go down here, select the delay, and again, introduce it with our volume option here. Okay, so when I bring that all in, see how it starts to blend. So that is essentially how you add reverb or delay or anything else for that matter to a bus, and how you then apply it. As I mentioned before, the reason why we do this is simply to save CPU and to kind of give us that all-in-one room feel, particularly for our instruments groups. So you may want to use one unit for your drums, you may decide to use another reverb unit for your synths, you may decide to use another reverb unit for your bass or piano or something like that. And so we can have essentially 3 or 4 different buses with different units on, but they are sitting separately as rooms of their own, in their own right. So we can, you know, I could even make the decision, actually, you know what, I'd rather send my drums through the same sort of reverb that I've sent my synth through, and I would simply come down here and change the option, and then I can adjust the reverb accordingly with this same option here. So if I play that back now, this is listening to the other reverb unit. Okay, so that is it. I hope that's been helpful. If you guys have any more questions, please feel free to email info@starcitystudios.co.uk. Otherwise, of course, you can find me on Twitter @P1Casso, and I'm always happy to answer any questions, and I love talking to you guys about music production and what you guys are up to. So if there's anything I can help with, please feel free to get in touch. I look forward to hearing from you guys soon, and of course there will be more tutorials coming in the coming weeks, so please stay tuned and please subscribe to the channel. Okay guys, have a great day, speak to you soon, bye bye.